Students, how are you? Welcome to my class. So today I'm going to continue with my same lesson, that is meaning and types of economy. And today I'm going to explain you all about the India as mixed economy. And there are some features also are there. So one by one I'm going to explain. So first, let me tell you all what do you mean by India as mixed economy. India is a classic example of mixed economy, with both public and private sectors operating within the planning and regulatory framework of the government. The need to achieve higher and faster development, ensuring guaranteeing better living standard to all classes of people. So this is the main planning development of the India as in a mixed economy. Together both private as well as the public together, it's working together only for the development of the speeder, faster achievements, society as well as the people living standard. So these are the features in the India as a mixed economy. So one by one I'm going to explain them. So the first one, that is in a coexistence of public and private sectors. Here, industrial policy of 1948 and 1956 formulated by the Indian government made the provisions for coexistence of the public and private sectors, with a large role for public sector, like basics of heavy industries were under the public sector. And the second one, that is a planned development. Here, 5 years plan was prepared within the framework of the directive principles of state policy to rebuild economy and lay foundations of industrial and scientific progress. So the planning commission has so far prepared, implemented, even they prepared, even implemented into the society, that is 12 5 year plans and many annual plans in 2015, and it was transformed to the NIT Aayog. Okay, from planning commission to, it is renamed to the NIT Aayog in the year 2015. And the third one, that is in a role of public sector. Here, the public sector has played an important role in the development of Indian economy, like development of infrastructure, like water supply, generation, transportation, communications, health facilities. So these all will come under the infrastructure. And establishment of basics for heavy industries and spread industries in every backward regions and all, and promoting trading and marketing activities, including that is an international trade also. And the next fourth one, that is in a private sector. In the private sector, it not only includes industries but agriculture, small industries, trade, and a great deal of activities in housing, construction activities as well. It provides employment to 3/4 of the manpower. Here, we are seeing the sectors like it is not only in the industries but in the agriculture also, industries also, trade, so activities, so manpower is needed. And the next, the last one, that is a coordination between the public and the private sectors. Here, both the public and the private, so here the private, the businessmen are called as a private, the public who consumes goods, services and all, so those are called as the public sectors, have worked together. Together they are working for the achieving the goals so set by the planning commission. So however, today the role of public sector is declining, means what, it is gradually, step by step, slowly it has been has become the modern, modernization, technology, machines. So manpower, the public, is day by day it is declining. So these are the features of the India as mixed economy. And the next, the last, that is performance of public sector in India. So in public, how the public are actively participating in the in our economy. So that thing we will come to. So when we come to the performance of the public sector in India, the public sector was given dominant, means what, important role, so that it could control the commanding heights of the economy and achievement of rapid economic development and reduction of concentration of economic power, balance regional development like local places, area, urban districts. So employment generation, producing more employment opportunities to the people, import substances, bringing the goods and goods from other countries and all, and export, promoting our goods in other countries and also resources, mobilizations were key objectives of the public sector. Promotions, public sector promotions. Public sector made a significant contribution to the country's economy by filling the gap in the industrial sector, generating employment and achieving balanced, that is in a regional developments, you know, like local places, areas and all. But the public sector did not show better financial performances and all, or profitability. It is not showed any kind of profit because of many because of some issues and all, like a defective pricing, so more pricing and all, and in the decision making it is not so quick, it is not so sure while making the decision and all, overstaffing, taking more employees required. What, how much it is required, that much they need it. More than that they have, that is called as the overstaffing, you know. And lack of accountability. So no proper accounts have been shown. And underutilization of capital, capacity. Hence, since 1980s, so what we see, the various sectors were made to improve performance, and with all the reform process that since from that time more efforts they were doing, more performance, but they could not come to that level at all. And they took initiative and they introduced in 1991, that is, so privatization has become a key policy of the government. And government also, what is doing is saving. So what its share of the public sector or public properties, industries, which is called disinvestment. Disinvestment means because funds are not there, so government is unable to look after the things and all. So what it's doing, it's selling the public properties to the privatization sectors. What are they taking? They are taking over sale properties by the government. They are looking after. So like this, so many properties of the government have been sale. Why? Because it has become the financial burden for the government for the sake of the maintenance and all. So these are the things. So what we are seeing here, the public sector is declining day by day. So many things are there, like financially overstaffing, employment generation, providing more employment opportunities and all, lack of accountability, lack of unity and pricing policies and all, and no proper decision making and all, overstaffing. So these are the drawbacks of the performance of the public sector in India. So still it is called as in a developing country, or it is also called as in a underdeveloping country. So here I have entered my lesson students. So three types of economy are. So one is in a capitalist, one is in a socialist, another one is in a mixed. Another one is in a, that is in a, India has in a mixed economy. Capitalist means what? It is called as the private sector. Only few people are manufacturing the good, the rest of all are called as in a consumers. The public socialist economy, that there is an interference of the government on behalf of the public, the government controlling the goods and services, and it is the government responsibility to share it equally. And when we come to the mixed, it is a both private as well as in a public together. It is in a coordination, coexistence together. We are looking for the better facilities of the standard of people as well as in a society. So these are the things we have learned in this lesson, that is the meaning and types of economy. And here I ended my lesson, students. If you have any doubts and queries, you can contact me. Thank you so much, students.